And they said there's a young heavyweight in the Catskills called Mike Tyson looking for sparring partners. I'd never heard of Mike Tyson. I was just happy to hear that he was 17, actually 6 months younger than me. And Mike came out and greeted me, and he was smaller than me, and he was younger than me, and he spoke with a bit of a lisp. And I thought, I'm going to batter him. You know, I didn't know what he was doing to men. He was a wrecking machine. He was just an incredible specimen of a man at 17.
And I got thrown on my head, and I heard a big cracking and crunching in my neck. And I got up, and my arms went numb. And I had to finish the match. It was the semifinals. I was playing Russian roulette with my body, but I knew that this might be the only time that I could compete in the Olympics. It's 6 ounces. It's fairly heavy because it's pretty dense, but it's not 100% gold. It's gold-plated silver. You believe those cheap bastards? They stopped making full gold after 1968.
I was walking away, and I heard a strange voice say, "Don't move." Now, obviously, at 5:30 in the morning, I was smoking crack, I was snorting heroin, I was paranoid, I was jumpy. When I heard that, I got spooked. So I went like that, turned around to see what it was. As soon as I did that, I got shot. Boom, boom, boom. Boom, boom, and then I got grazed right here.
Okay, so you were very kind to sign a beautiful shirt for me from that game. Okay, where am I? So that means a lot to me, Edwin. Thank you so much for that. Really appreciate it. I wanted to wear it for the interview.
It's probably a little bit too big for you.
It's far too big for me, 5'8". Who was the craziest person, like the most famous person you remember walking through your doors? And this was just normal, just to meet your dad or to train with him.
It would have been Andre.
Oh, wow.
Andre the Giant.
He fit through the door?
Barely. And he was a giant. I was terrified of him, and he didn't want to scare me. Mm-hmm. And I just remember looking up at him like, yeah, he's just so impressive to look at.
So they come out with an offer for me to do this thing. This was in, I don't know, season 3 of Friends.
Yeah, it was one of the earlier ones. Mm-hmm.
It was like 95, I think. And it was so down my street, you know? And I had so much fun on it. And then they reprised the role 2 or 3 times. But I lost a tremendous amount of weight. I mean, I was exhausted. And I weighed about 70 pounds less than I do now. And they're all very sweet. And they all go, "Hey, wow, you look great."
They're not that good at acting.
But that one person who just, to say it to my face in front of people at a weigh-in, I could have walked away, get no help, believe what they said. And you know what? I had to get help. I really had to get help. My mind was, I thought, I still believed in my mind. Even though I had clear reports from UCLA, I believed in my mind that I was going to die. For some reason, I just believed that.